Hi, welcome back to the second episode of this year's Herald podcast. My name is Alina Fairle. I'm a senior, and I'm the editor-in-chief of our newspaper. Today, we're here with two seniors to talk about FAFSA updates for anybody who's interested.
Hi, my name is Jayshree Santos.
Hi, my name is Maria Zaya.
FAFSA is an online application for prospect college students who wish to enroll into a higher education program with financial support. FAFSA is a completely free program that allows students to receive additional / supplemental funds to enroll in higher education programs. Students throughout the year are eligible to apply, and this year, the online FAFSA form became available in January after a slight delay at the start of the year. It is notable that the FAFSA is on a first-come, first-served basis, meaning that students who apply early in the year are much more likely to receive more aid as well as anticipate financial packages early.
One significant update that the FAFSA had this year is how they took out the drug convictions questions. That means that without any type of prejudice, these questions have been removed, allowing more students to have more access to financial aid, especially if they need higher education.
Mm-hmm. Another notable change in is expansion of eligibility for the Pell Grant, which is a need-based grant provided by the federal government to low-income undergraduate students.
Something new that FAFSA has added is how you can take your direct documents from the IRS and put it into the tax income section of the application. That is easier for students, especially the ones that don't get support from their parents, or it's really hard for them to get this type of information.
Overall, these updates to the FAFSA aim to make the financial application process more accessible, efficient, and equitable for students seeking to further their education.
Thank you guys so much for coming on.
Thank you for having us.
Hi, I'm Jaylene Alonzo, and I'm here to talk about bullying. Bullying is when someone hurts you or makes you feel bad on purpose. Bullying can happen anywhere, at school, online, in the neighborhood, where you least expect it. Bullying is not cool and it's not okay.
If you see someone being bullied, you can help. You can speak with them and let them know you care. You can also tell the person who is bullying that what they're doing is not okay. It's also important to tell a trusted adult, like a teacher or a parent. Helping and standing up for others shows empathy, which means you care about how other people feel.
You can also say no to bullying by kind and respectful to everyone, no matter how they look, talk, or act. You can celebrate diversity, which means you appreciate the difference that make us all unique. You can also learn to get along with others even when you don't agree with them.
Remember, you have the power to make a difference. You can help make your school a safe place for everyone. So join me and say no to bullying today.
Hola, yo soy Jaylene Alonso y vengo a hablar sobre el acoso escolar. Acoso escolar es cuando alguien te hace daño o te hace sentir mal a propósito. El acoso escolar puede ocurrir en cualquier parte, en la escuela, por internet, en el vecindario, donde menos te lo esperas. El acoso escolar no es divertido y no está bien.
Si ves que alguien está siendo víctima de acoso escolar, puedes ayudarle. Puedes hablar con ellos y hacerles saber que te importan. También puedes decirle a la persona que acosa que lo que está haciendo no está bien. También es importante contárselo a un adulto de confianza, como un maestro o aún de sus padres. Ayudar y defender a los demás demuestra empatía, lo que significa de preocuparse por cómo se sienten los demás.
También puedes decir no al acoso escolar siendo amable y respetuoso con los demás, sin importar su apariencia, su forma de hablar o su forma de actuar. Puedes celebrar la diversidad, lo que significa que expresas lo que hace diferente a cada persona. Puedes aprender a llevarte bien con los demás, aunque no estés de acuerdo con ellos. Recuerda, respeta a cada quien, su opinión, su forma de verse, su forma de vestirse. Todo hace diferente y todo no hace su único. No acosa a nadie solamente por su forma de ver, cómo se ve o cómo actúa. Recuerda, respeta para que todo el mundo te respete.
Recuerda, tú tienes el poder de marcar la diferencia. Tú puedes ayudar a que tu escuela sea un lugar seguro para todos. Así que únete a mí y di no al acoso escolar hoy mismo.
Welcome back. I'm here with Jaisalee Santos and junior Kylie Blaha to talk about some softball updates. So how's your season been going?
It's been going pretty good. We were just pretty sad because the weather's been canceling a lot of games and we've been practicing inside. So we're really looking forward to the nice weather and playing in the sun.
Tell me about your team.
Our team this season is very well structured. I feel like we all understand the basics of softball, and I feel like we're a very strong team this season and hoping that we can make it to states as well as we did last season.
And how were tryouts this year?
Tryouts this year, we had a lot of girls try out. It was very competitive, and you know, I feel like we all had a good time. And anything else you want to add, Kylie?
There was like a lot of talent that showed up, and we're really happy with the amount of girls that came.
All right, thank you, guys. And now we're here with Gracie Chesmore, our sports editor of the Herald, to talk about Athlete of the Season.
So here at HHS, we do Athlete of the Season every season, so fall, winter, and spring for our sports. And right now is our winter edition. We are closing out. And we've been doing this for about 2 years now. And basically, voting opened Monday night. We created a Google form with a list of students from each sport. We post the link so anyone in Holyoke High can vote on who their favorite athlete of the season was. Our athlete right now for athlete of the winter season, voting closes Thursday night, so anyone still can vote right now. And the winner will be announced Friday with the post.
Did we do one last season?
We did. We did fall, and Ava Tellier won for field hockey for the fall edition.
And this year, I joined Unified Track, and it's a great opportunity for students who want to be involved.
Are there a lot of people participating this year for Unified Track?
Yes, both helping and participating.
Do you guys have any meets coming up?
We have a meet every Thursday once a week.
Thank you guys for coming. And joining us now is our Herald advisor, Mr. Zaria, to talk about restorative justice with Junior Nalani.
So I just want to talk about a few things about restorative justice with Nalani here. So I'm just going to ask a few questions, and then we'll get more information about the program. So first things first, I want to ask Nalani, what are some things, or for students who don't know more precisely, what is exactly restorative justice?
Restorative justice is a program which we practice here in Holyoke High School. We create a safe space for students where we help de-escalate their problems, and yeah.
Nice. So one thing I want to follow up with is kind of like, what are the takeaways students get from attending these programs, attending these meetings or these reunions?
I think communication is a big factor that they take away, because they're allowed to get vulnerable around their friends, and they're more comfortable talking with each other.
So communication is key for conflict resolution, it sounds like. Nice. So one thing I want to ask lastly is, for students who kind of like want to navigate with this program and kind of like find it, where can they find this program? Who can they talk to get more information about this resource?
You're able to ask me about it, or you're able to ask Mr. Maldonado, Felix, or Justin.
Nice. Thank you for sharing with that. Thank you for sharing that with us today.
I have a question. What's the difference between Roots and Palante? Sorry to throw you off.
I don't know much about Palante at all, but Roots is like a new program that they wanted to try, and Holyoke High School is like one of the first schools to try it.
So it's like across multiple schools, do you think?
I think so.
All right, so maybe we'll talk about Palante on the next podcast. Thank you guys for coming.
Thank you for having us.
And for our last segment, we have Junior Amaya Garcia joining us to talk about the recent solar eclipse that happened this Monday.
As many people know, April 8th was the total eclipse, and science teachers at Holyoke High gave us ISL certified glasses so that many students were able to watch the eclipse. The first thing that many students did after we got out of school was put our glasses on to watch the eclipse. And the moon was only covering the sun a little bit, but later into the day, around 3:30, the moon was covering the sun, so it was almost in a crescent shape. The moon was barely meeting the sun, but it was still visible. And at around 3:30, totality happened, where it got dark outside. It was a beautiful phenomenon, and I'm grateful that we were all able to experience this and that our teachers gave us glasses to watch this moment.
And I thought it was interesting, like, in our area, the eclipse was only, like, 95%. It was 90, that's, like, it seems like a lot, but mm-hmm. It was still not that dark outside. Yeah. And then, like, I looked at clips from, like, I know Burlington, Vermont, and Syracuse, New York, they were in 100% totality, and, like, it was completely dark outside, so, like, the 5% difference changed.
The next eclipse won't be visible to us until 2044, unless we want to travel overseas to Europe or to the Arctic to see the next eclipse in 2026.
All right, thank you so much for coming on, and thank you for watching our podcast. Stay tuned.